Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles: The Rise of the TMNT is a very, very good movie. Oh, it's pretty good. I normally preferred like 2012. I haven't really watched that much Rise of TMNT. I watched like the first few episodes and I thought it was pretty good. Obviously the art style is the best thing about the movie. It looks absolutely gorgeous. And the characters are quite funny as well. I really like it. Obviously I think the middle part of the movie is a bit slow, but apart from that, it's pretty funny with some pretty decent jokes around here, and the ending's really good. Like, the ending's absolutely incredibly good. I like how there's a character arc. It's kind of weird, the character arc. It's kind of like, like, you knew it was coming. Like, you knew Leo was gonna have a character arc because he's an actual dick before he becomes a not dick. So it's fine. It's fine what they've done for the characters in this TMNT. I don't really like how they've kind of done them. Like, obviously, I like how they've done Donnie and stuff like that. Obviously, I don't like what they did to, like, Raph and stuff like that. But it's pretty good. Like, it's pretty good here. Like, it's just a pretty good movie. And, yeah, 7 out of 10. Let's move on to the next one. Okay, so now I'm going to talk about Avatar: The Way of Water. It's a very good movie. Like, it's a little bit overrated in my opinion. I didn't like it as much as some other people did. It's... If you haven't seen my letterbox on it, my review is just too long. Just those two words. It's too long! I know it's James Cameron, and I know it's Avatar, but holy fuck is this movie longer than it needs to be. Especially at the end, when there's the flipped over ship. They're in that ship for like... ever! They are literally there for... like, 45 minutes, well, it feels like. And it doesn't really advance the plot. The middle of the movie is actually pretty good. I wasn't really into it at the start, but the middle was actually really good with some amazing visuals. Especially with the big whales and shit, that was nice. It's just kind of the same thing, but Jake being, like, let, like, more of his own, like, thing now. And him having, like, kids. That stuff is pretty good. Like, it's a high 7 out of 10. I was thinking of an 8, but then I realised I was quite bored throughout it. It's very, like, slow sometimes. And it's very good, though. It is good. With some actually good moments in it that actually are really good. Like, the effects are probably the best in any movie I've ever seen. Excluding one movie, which is Blade Runner 2049. But that didn't come out this year, so I really like it. Moving on, 7 out of 10. I did not expect to like the bad guys that much. Like, holy shit, this movie is actually good. Like, oh my god, this movie is actually, like, really good. And I'm confused because people always say this movie is just kind of decent. Like, okay. It's not, bro. It's not the same thing I watched. At least for me, I really liked it. It was, like, had some actual decent jokes. A lot of the characters were good. Some of the bad parts of it were, I didn't really connect with many of the characters outside of Snake and Wolf. Wolf is probably one of the best protagonists I've actually seen. Like, no joke, he's actually quite good. I like how they're all very good at, like, robbing places, and they all have, a very good talent. They are, like, and the whole, like, thing Wolf goes through to actually get the thing, you know? Like, actually. And the animation looks so, so good. I love the style that they went for, and it definitely paid off. It looks so Spider-Verse-y in a good way. Well, Spider-Verse is anything. Anything Spider-Verse is in a good way. But I also think that it's actually just crazy good. Like, oh my god, bro. It's not anything really deep. It didn't make me cry or anything, but it's just a fun movie. Like, it's just fun. I think it's really good. All of the cool tricks and stuff they pull off is actually quite good. The voice acting is really good. The animation is really good. The soundtrack is really good. And it's just a fun movie. I could rewatch it a million times and I wouldn't get old of it. I love this movie, bro. 8 out of 10. I don't know why you guys hate it. Gotta love it, bro. Everything Everywhere All at Once is a very good movie that's kind of weird and overrated as well. It's overrated, but yeah, I still think it's a 9 out of 10. It's really good, bro. Like, a lot of everything kind of works in this movie, especially at the start and kind of near the middle. I really like the characters in this one. They're very good. And it gets dark quickly, and it's bad shit crazy. The thing I don't like about the movie is how goofy it is. Like, there's a lot of weird things, like the whole sausage fingers thing is just, it's not funny. It's just not. There's a few jokes that made me laugh. Like, it's funny overall. Like, it made me laugh quite a few times. But I wouldn't say this is a 10 out of 10. Like, I would never, ever think that. Like, the effects are gorgeous, but that doesn't make a movie a 10 out of 10. It's got, like, problems, you know? It's got loads of problems. Stretching from it being too goofy to it not really having that much of a coherent plot sometimes. Obviously, the final battle's good, and the whole villain thing is quite good as well. And the whole costume design, everything about that bit is really good. But, yeah, like, it's very good. It's amazing. I really love the concept. I love how difficult it is. I really like when they're, like, on rocks, on, like, on top of a mountain. That bit is so good. There's a lot of good elements and concepts used so well. And it's just, oh my god, it's kind of trippy as well. I don't know, probably because I'm like quite young. Like, it's just like, I don't really get it. You just kind of flash between one thing and another, and it's anxiety inducing, but in a good way. And it's just really good. All the sets look so good. I love this movie. It's great. Probably won't watch it for a bit of more of a time, but I will watch it again sometime. Alright. 9 out of 10. Let's get to it. To talk about Top Gun Maverick is to talk about anything. Top Gun Maverick is absolutely phenomenal. It's actually a 10 out of 10. Like, it's actually astounding. I didn't see that many movies. I saw 11 this year. And only 5 of them were 7 out of 10s and above. Which meant they were good movies. And this one, oh my god, bro, I've seen it twice, and I'm questioning a third time, because, oh my god, bro, this movie is absolutely phenomenal. The effects are great. It's the continuation of Top Gun that feels so effortlessly good. It's just a movie you can vibe with that's fun, quite funny, true to the original. Tom Cruise's performance is incredible. And it's, the best parts are the flying sequences because of how visceral and real they feel. Everything works with this movie. Everything. From the flying scenes to the incredible cast of characters like Hangman and Bob and Goose. And the struggle between Goose and Maverick is actually really good. I like when they hijack a plane at the end, and it's really good how Tom Cruise, aka Maverick, is just kind of like this guy who's like kind of a misfit as well. And like, this whole mission's being brought up and stuff like that, and the training and the incredible music that's brought into it, and the nice visuals, it's just, oh my god. Everyone likes this movie, to be honest, guys. Like, it's not really deep or anything as well. It's just a fun movie. It's just like a really good blockbuster movie. that stays so true to the original while also expands upon it with the new planes and them having to use old planes to get into the middle of like the mission thing that they're doing. It's also very emotional, not like to cry to, but like it's got good emotion to it. But last Top Gun Maverick, guys, you love it. See you later. 10 out of 10, bye.